Greetings. Thank you, Aziz, for your comment. I would like to clearly answer it. This man that giving a rebuttal to Ahmed Didat concerning the promised comforter knows this. Why couldn't he challenge Ahmed Didat when he was alive, or write his pastors that used to debate Ahmed Didat? I believe that all these things that this man proved to discredit Muhammad from being the promised comforter will be dismantled by Ahmed Didat. First, let us establish the claim by Islam, okay, brother? Didat was Islam's most vocal claimant that the comforter Jesus promised was Muhammad. Didat and Islam must make this claim to defend Surah 7, 157 and 158, and Surah 61, 6. However, brother, I think any honest man must respect all that Jesus said about the Comforter. So please read with me, brother, the description that Jesus gave. Jesus describes the Comforter in three different but close passages, brother. For now, let's just look at the first passage from Jesus, brother. John 14. John 14:11. Believe in me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very work's sake. Jesus called God his Father over and over. In fact, Jesus here said God was in him. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. Jesus again called God his Father. And whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. Jesus says he will do whatever we ask after he goes to God. But after Jesus goes to God, Jesus is dead, brother. Jesus is saying he will answer prayers after he goes to God, after he is dead, brother. If you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. If you love me, keep my commandments. If you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. Jesus is saying, I will do anything you ask in his name after he is dead. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he, the comforter, may abide with you forever. Jesus said the comforter will live with the disciples forever. Please read it again, brother, for yourself. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he, the comforter, may abide with you forever. Jesus continues to describe the comforter. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But you know him, for he dwells with you, and shall be in you. That description is loaded, brother. Make sure you read it all. Whom the world cannot receive because it seeth him not. The world, meaning non-believers, cannot see the Comforter, brother. But you know him, meaning the Comforter, for he, the Comforter, dwells with you and shall be in you. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. Yet a little while, and the world seeth me no more. But you see me, because I live, you shall also live. At that day you shall know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. He that has my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loves me, and he that loves me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him, and will manifest myself to him. And a few verses later, Jesus again speaks of the Comforter. These things have I spoken unto you, being yet present with you. Jesus identifies then, when he was yet present with the disciples. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, I want you to really see this, brother. Jesus names who the Comforter is, the Holy Spirit. This so clearly damns Muhammad's claim that Islam and Didat know they must attack this. So let's again clearly document Islam's attempted argument to attack this part of the description of the Comforter by Jesus. This is Islam's logic. Jesus will send the Comforter, so the Comforter cannot be here already. The Holy Spirit is here already, therefore the Holy Spirit cannot be the Comforter. I really want you to know, my Muslim brother, I know and understand the argument Islam and Didat make. Now, brother, please allow me to show you exactly where the error is and why Islam is wrong. You must look back at what Jesus said about the Comforter. Even the Spirit of Truth, whom the world cannot receive because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but you know him, for he dwells with you. Remember Islam's argument, the Comforter cannot be here already. That is what Islam imagines and argues, brother. The Comforter cannot be here already. But what did Jesus actually say? But you know him, for he dwells with you and shall be in you. That means the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, was already with the disciples, brother. The Comforter was already here, according to Jesus, the one who revealed and described the Comforter. So Jesus clearly states that the Comforter is already with the disciples, while Islam must argue the Comforter cannot be here. Perhaps Islam must argue Jesus is stupid and dead wrong, and that one irrefutable fact damns the claim Muhammad is the Comforter. The Comforter was already here, was already known to the disciples, brother. Add to that, brother, the Holy Spirit came as Jesus promised. The Holy Spirit came to live in the disciples during their lives, just as Jesus said. Luke 24:49, "And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you, but tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high." Now this is really critical for you to understand, my Muslim brother. Jesus told his living, breathing disciples to wait in Jerusalem until the Comforter came. Now, brother, that creates two possible scenarios you may choose to believe. Jesus told his disciples to wait. They did. And 50 days later, the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, came. In this scenario, Jesus said the promise and then fulfilled his promise. Or you may choose to believe the scenario created by Islam's and Didat's argument. The Islamic scenario is that Jesus promised the Comforter to the living, breathing Muslim followers of Jesus. Remember, the Quran claims the disciples were good Muslims who swore to follow Allah. So Jesus told good Muslims to wait in Jerusalem for the Comforter. But Muhammad, the Comforter, would not come for 600 years. Muhammad, the Comforter, would not come to the disciples. Essentially, Jesus lied to his good Muslim disciples. This is the reality of the Islamic scenario claiming Muhammad is the Comforter. It demands that Jesus be a liar. And as I read this, brother, another issue comes to mind. Let's forget that Muhammad came over 500 years after the disciples died. There is a begging question that Jesus introduces. Why did Jesus say, wait in Jerusalem? Mohammed never went to Jerusalem. The word Jerusalem is not even mentioned in the whole Quran. If Mohammed is the comforter, and Jesus is giving instructions to the disciples to go to the place where they will meet the comforter, and Jesus is saying to wait until the comforter comes, why, O Muslim, did Jesus say, go to and wait at a place Muhammad would never go? If Muhammad is the comforter, Jesus would have to say, go to Mecca or Medina and have your descendants wait there for 15 generations. That is another damning problem for Islam's and Didat's argument, brother. So Christian truth, Jesus promises, disciples wait, Holy Spirit comes as promised. Or Didat's claim, Jesus promises, Jesus lies, the Muslim disciples are disappointed. Jesus himself proved it was not Muhammad. That is enough for an honest man. The question for you, brother, is do you have any regard for the honest truth? Do you have any regard for what Prophet Jesus actually said? Do you have any regard for logic or the facts? If Muhammad is not the comforter, Islam is wrong and Didat is wrong, brother. In fact, I know Muhammad is not the comforter. I know Didat is wrong, brother. And I know Islam is wrong. Islam's whole claim that a comforter is even promised, brother, is because the Bible records the promise that Jesus made to his disciples. It is willful ignorance, ignoring the facts, to respect only the word comforter and disrespect every other word Jesus said about the comforter. And you Christians watching this, know that you know that you know the comforter is the Holy Spirit. The promise was fulfilled. Islam's claim is an error. Worse, it is a desperate fraud. Do not be deceived, dear brothers and sisters. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.